Carlos, and today I want to show you some of the upgrades that are included in the new render boss, version 1.2. First, let's talk real quick about the Mac version. It's still in beta, but we're implementing the feedback that we've been getting from everybody using it. As of this video, there are some smaller things that the Mac version still doesn't have, including some of the new features that I'll talk about later in this video. And there are still some kinks to iron out for sure, but overall it's working well for most people, and we're planning for all the features to match by next year. So if you have a Mac, or several, you can already use Render Boss for what it does best, which is render with multiple threads or multiple machines, and the license is cross-platform, so you can mix and match Macs and PCs in the same network. Visit the link below if you want to get it. All right, let's move on to the new features. There are several fixes and features, but I'll just talk about the more interesting ones. And let's start with a small one, but it's actually really useful, and that is mobile notifications. This is great because it lets you walk away from your computer while it renders, and when it finishes, you can get a notification on your phone, and then you know it's done. So yeah, it's really handy. For now, we support them through Pushbullet, which is free for iOS and Android, and we might add more services in the future if there's demand for it. There are also several upgrades to the UI. Some are to simplify or clarify procedures, but in general, there's more information about what's happening with your renders. For example, the Jobs tab now gives you more information about renders that are happening in a different machine. You can see how many machines are working on it, the progress, and the estimated time to finish. The Job Info page now has more useful details as well, including a list of all the files and all the effects that you need to render a particular job. And it even highlights them if the files are offline or the effects are not installed. And those are just a few examples. My favorite visual change are the new graphs for multi-threaded renders. These are really helpful to find which amount of threads is the fastest for a particular job. And there are two charts. The first one is a simple plot of how long each frame has taken over the course of the render. And the dots here mark thread changes, so you can see over time if adding or removing threads made it faster or slower. The second chart is even more interesting to me. It has these bars that tell you, in average, how many seconds it takes to render a frame at any given number of threads. And this is really handy to see which amount of threads is the fastest for a particular job. And actually, that leads me to the next thing, which is we've upgraded the automatic thread manager. The previous version was designed to monitor the CPU and RAM usage and add as many threads as possible to max out the computer. But over time, we realized that sometimes the computer can handle lots of threads, but since they all still share the same GPU and RAM, after a certain point, the render actually got slower. It depends on the resolution, the effects used, and a lot of other factors, but often just a few threads is faster than, you know, maxing out the machine. So this new version takes all that into account, and instead of looking at the CPU and RAM usage, it now looks at just how fast the render is actually going, basically the graphs I just talked about. And then it tries to add or remove threads, and just to try to find the right amount that will render the fastest, regardless of what the CPU and RAM usages are doing. The last thing I want to talk about are remote renders, and this is my favorite of the new features because it allows you to send renders over the internet. And that doesn't sound like that big of a deal, but it actually opens the door to having your own virtual render machines or even render farms on the cloud. You can now rent virtual machines from services like AWS or Paperspace, and immediately double or triple your render power. The cool thing is that you can grow or shrink the amount of extra machines depending on the project, and that you cannot easily do if you're actually buying additional machines. I made a separate video just about remote renders where I go deeper into it and explain how to actually do it. I just wanted to mention it here because, like I said, it's my favorite new feature, so, but you can check out the full video on this link below, and yeah. And that's it for now. If you have automatic updates enabled, or if you're in the beta track, you probably already have this version installed. Otherwise, you can download it on the link below. Feel free to reach out if you have questions. Otherwise, I'll see you in the next video. Bye.